What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Ray with a back here, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you the most over-effective tactic on defense in Madden 19. This will change the way you play defense in Madden 19. So if this is your first time checking out one of my videos and you want to stay up to date on the best Madden tips and gameplay all year long, consider subscribing below and hitting the bell icon so that you join the notification squad. So this video is going to be the best way to play defense in Madden 19. It's not going to be a video on, hey, run this formation or run this blitz or use this coverage. No, this is going to be about one specific tactic that you can apply no matter what defense you run. Any formation, any coverage, you can apply this tactic, and it is the best tactic currently in the game. So the best zone in the game right now by far is the QB spy. And you're probably thinking, how is that possible? Well, I'm going to show you in this video. You put a defensive lineman in a QB spy and he will lock down everything over the short middle of the field. And he'll usually pick the ball off. And you're going to see how crazy this is in this video. So you want to take a defensive lineman, put him in a spy. You do this by pressing A or X, depending on what system you're on. A on Xbox, X on PS4, and then you go left on the right stick. Now, to prove my point, I'm taking my outside linebackers and I'm getting them out of the way. So there's nobody over the middle of the field but Daniels, who I'm putting in a spy. He is the only coverage over the middle of the field. I'm spreading out all my wide receivers so that Antonio Brown is the only route that I could possibly be throwing to. Look how deep Antonio Brown is, and look what the spy does. He's not letting it get over him. He's not having it. And this isn't a fluke. We're going to run it a bunch of times. So you can see, again, I'm going to get all my wide receivers out the way. I'm going to get my outside linebackers out the way. So it's just, I want to show you just how effective it is. One-on-one, you have a spy over the middle, nothing else, and you have Antonio Brown running deep behind him. Because I don't want to throw any routes under him and you think, oh, you're throwing to the low route. No, I'm throwing to Antonio Brown. Now there, the spy blitzed in. That'll happen every once in a while because he is on the D-line. Sometimes the block will engage him before he drops back, but it's not going to kill your play or anything. You still have tons of coverage on the field, but just know that every once in a while the spy might get engaged in a block. So we're going to run it again. Again, no zones over the middle but him, and Antonio Brown's the only guy I can be throwing to. Look how much space Antonio Brown has behind him, and again, the defensive lineman is not letting it happen. He is not letting it get over him. Now, yes, he's dropping the ball, but anytime you get an incomplete pass, you're still winning that down. That's a win for the defense, but in game, they definitely do pick the ball off a lot more. They really do. Look, again, he's not letting it happen. And I have a clip I'll show you at the end. I do have a clip of the defensive tackle picking a spy. So I'll show that a little bit more later in the video. But either way, if you're getting an incomplete pass off of this, that's still a win for the defense, especially if it's third or fourth down and you get that to happen. You're good money. Watch again. Spy's not he's not letting it happen. Look how much room Antonio Brown has behind him. There's no way he should be doing that. Now, will this get patched? Maybe. Who knows? I don't think this is like a real pressing issue for EA right now, so I don't think it's going to be patched anytime soon. It may get patched eventually, but right now, if you're not putting a QB spy on every play, you're doing it wrong. And I don't care if you're running cover 2, cover 3, I don't care if you're running man defense, I don't care if you're blitzing, whatever you're doing, you need to put a defensive lineman in a spy. Now, another thing you want to consider is put your tallest guy here. Put your guy that has best jump here, guy that has good catch. So think J.J. Watt, for example. If you're playing with the Texans, yes, you would like J.J. Watt to be rushing, but if you put him in a spy, not only is he going to do what Daniels is doing here, but he's going to probably pick the ball off almost every time because he's J.J. Watt and he actually can jump. That's what he's known for, is getting up and swatting passes. But, you know, if you got a guy that's 6'7 or something on your line, you want to put him in the spy. It's going to be extremely hard to get the ball over him. Now, how do you beat this? This is how you beat it right here. What I did right there was I threw a high point pass. That is the only way to get it over his head on a route that is, you know, unless you're on like a deep post and you got like 20 yards behind the spy, you need to throw a high point pass. But the problem with that is right here, you see how there was coverage there. The guy hit him and ripped the ball out. So it's the only way to really get it over the spy. But you have to also keep in mind that because of the coverage there, coming down with the ball could be harder. Now, you could kind of try to scramble out with your QB a little bit to get the spy to move with you and then throw the route over the middle. That also works as well. But just keep in mind, if you're trying to stand still in the pocket and throw a regular bullet pass, that spy is going to get his hands on it every time, as you can see. So I hope that you found this video helpful. Definitely use this tactic because it will change your defense. I guarantee you will get more stops with this method. But yeah, anyway, if you enjoyed the video and found it helpful, as always, just drop a like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.